Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ziad, Crohn's disease patient, NHS worker and educator, here bringing you IBD facts and taboo breaking chats. Don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel. So, let's get started. So the first type of medication we're going to look at is aminosalicylates. Aminosalicylates are medications that contain 5-aminosalicylic acid and are often known as 5-ASAs. They are often the first type of treatment people with IBD go on. They are designed to reduce inflammation in the lining of the intestine and are usually the first line of medications in those with IBD who experience mild to moderate symptoms, and it can help them either achieve or maintain remission. 5-ASAs can be used for both Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. However, current evidence suggests that they are less effective at inducing remission in those with Crohn's disease in comparison to inducing and maintaining remission in ulcerative colitis. The most common types of 5-ASAs used to treat IBD include Balsalazide, Mesalazine, Olsalazine and Sulfasalazine. As mentioned, there are many different types of 5-ASAs as they come in different forms and formulations such as tablets, granules, enemas or suppositories, and the type of 5-ASA that is given will depend on where the intestinal inflammation is located, as each one is designed so the medication can survive in the body until it reaches that inflamed area. Aminosalicylates such as sulfasalazine are broken down into sulpyridine and 5-aminosalicylic acid, which both have anti-inflammatory properties. With tablets and granules, they are designed so when they reach the correct pH level in the body, the protective coating around them breaks down. This releases the medication, which is then broken down further into its active ingredients that can help reduce the inflammation in the intestines. With suppositories and enemas, these are inserted directly into the rectum, wherefore suppositories will then dissolve to provide their anti-inflammatory effects to reduce inflammation.